had found a toy tester first. If you remember, that was the role Tom Hanks played in the movie hit Big.
So what did it make you do for all this?
Well, I play with all of this stuff, and then I go in and I tell them what I think.
That's it?
Yeah.
And they pay you for that?
Yeah.
Suckers!
Oh, thank you, Miss Patterson. Hey, Miss Patterson, could you call down to media and have them send up the videotape of the Giants-Broncos Super Bowl and have them edit out all the commercials and the talking and stuff?
Yes, Mr. Baskin.
Thanks.
You're the luckiest guy I know.
Well, once again, life imitates art. I would like to introduce you to Mary Rodas, who is 14 and a toy tester for the Catco Company. Good morning. Thank you for coming in.
Good morning.
You test toys and they pay you for that?
Yes, they pay me, but not the way you're thinking of it. The way they pay me is they pay my high school and college education, and I have my own stocks portfolio.
That's not too bad. That's not too bad. What makes you so clever about helping design toys?
Well, I'm a kid, and I always around kids, and I always see what they want, and I always could compare what do they think from other ideas.
So you ask the other kids that you go to school with and throw around ideas and bring it back to the company and talk about it?
Well, first I do my own market research, so I bring in the products during snack time, or where there's a break, and I just say, what do you think of the product? So they just later on just tell me what they think about it, give me some ideas, which we already had the idea of, but just like that we think of it how they think of it.
Well, now here's a product that you brought into school. This is a pillow with some sort of a design on it. What kind of changes did you make on this?
Well, she had a beauty mark at first. At first I thought it was a pimple, but it was a beauty mark, and at this time I didn't know what was a beauty mark. So later on, the inventor explained me what was a beauty mark. So then I, like, a kid won't know that's a beauty mark at all.
Good point. I take it around. Now, you also had worked on, I have some paddles here. These are for some sort of small tennis game. What changes did you make in these paddles?
Well, we're trying to get them for balls, but I did my own market research again. So from all these three, the one you have right here with the red one, that was too wiggly, and you couldn't get a good firm.
Okay, I agree with that.
With the balls.
What's the matter with this one?
That was firm. That was the best we had so far we bought.
This is the one you liked. You didn't like this one?
It was too heavy, and plus it was too small to hit with the Balzac.
Okay. And the Balzac, I take it, is this balloon ball that you also worked on?
Yes.
Now, as I remember reading, this was originally supposed to have been, this is a balloon with a cover on it.
Yes.
And it was originally white.
Yes, white muslin.
And so what changes did you make into it?
Well, I made changing on the patterns and the packaging. The patterns, today's colors are neons, bright neon colors. So kids will like neons, and that stands out so many times. Seen people with neon shirts and all stuff.
So, do you ever have any ideas for new toys yourself in development? I mean, for example, if someone was to say, give you carte blanche to create any kind of toy, what might you bring out?
Not really. Maybe once in a while, yes, but it never worked out much, really. I just helped develop the product better.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for joining us on this. Neon ball.